Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv. And you know I'm on the high side of my weight fluctuation when I'm spending 10 minutes adjusting camera angles to reduce the number of double chins. Back in grade school, a million years ago, our shop teacher, his name was Mr. Weatherson. He was a very robust man. We used to call him Mr. Weatherchin. Why? Because the man had more chins than a Chinese phone book. Moving right along, we're here to talk about data and that failed 5 terabyte RAID array and a few other things. Listen, when you deconstruct it and you look at your own personal computer system, your system at home or your home office, what's the most important thing? The most important thing, without any doubt, is the actual data. As we all know, personal computers, Macs, PCs, everything else out there, they're commodity items. We pay through the nose for the bleeding edge systems. And then a few years later, they're worthless. You can wipe your ass with them. Now listen, coming from someone that's owned PCs and Macs and everything else since like the year of the flood, since the Stone Age, since when they invented fire or silicon chips. Yeah, this crap's worthless, except for a few select systems. But the most important commodity, the most important thing that's close to your heart, is your data. Maybe it's data that runs your home-based business. Maybe it's your digital photo collection, movie collection, source material, music, porn, whatever you got. It's all about the data. Now, I thought I was
invincible.
I have a 5 terabyte external RAID array. And here is the 5 terabyte Stardom RAID array. It's basically its own intelligent subsystem. You speak to it via the browser. There's an onboard computer system that handles the configuration of the drives. These are the individual 1 terabyte Hitachi server class UltraStar drives. And there's indeed a status control panel. And if you see any of the lights over here go red, that's where you shit your pants and you swap it out with another drive, and then it rebuilds the RAID. On the RAID array, there was a lot of data warehouse, and I even had that redundantly backed up. I had it backed up to independent hard drives that were stuffed in a box and shoved in the closet. The 5 terabyte RAID array failed. Not a physical failure. Not a physical failure. Not a hardware malfunction. Hardware malfunction, not a problem. I have 5 1 terabyte Hitachi server class drives in that system, the Stardom RAID array. And I have a backup 1 terabyte Hitachi server class drive in storage. So if there's a physical problem with one of the drives, I yank the bad drive out, I put the good one in, it rebuilds the array, etc., moving right along. Still though, the RAID array doesn't protect us from logical failures. Now, I really don't know exactly how or why it failed. Basically, the directory structure got wiped out. I have a couple of ideas. ScreenFlow was capturing one of my morning webcasts. It was in the process of writing out like a 50 gigabyte file. And ScreenFlow reported some type of a file error and the machine locked up. It had a hard reset. And then the next time I turned it on, it couldn't recognize the external RAID array. Was it a ScreenFlow problem? Was it a software problem that it locked up? Was it the X1900 video card, which I heard overheats, and I have experienced other lockups? Not sure. Or was it just good old-fashioned OS X vomiting on writing the directory structure? I don't know, and at this point I don't care. But here's the kicker. I said, alright, no big deal, I'll just reformat the drive and reload the data from the external drives that I have in the closet. And how about this for chaos theory? One of the external drives had a physical failure. Head crashed. If you turn the thing on, the thing would go clunk. So, pretty much screwed. Now, let me show you the software products that I purchased. Oh, and I bought them all. Here's a TechStool Pro, Data Rescue 2, Drive Genius, and from Alsoft, Disk Warrior. Okay, let's talk about the individual products. Drive Genius by ProSoft. This product was more, as it says on the box, maintenance and management. Data Rescue by ProSoft, this is the one that you use after you have a crash. And I tell you, this product was incredible. It was incredible. And I was able to restore some data off the RAID array. TechStool Pro, a little disappointed. I had version 4, and I just upgraded to the new one, version 5. Let me just confirm that. Again, this one is good for preventive maintenance, and it also does complete scans of all the hardware and whatnot. When the drive had crashed, I ran one of the scavenge utilities to scavenge files, and it ran for over 3 days. And it did find data. Unfortunately, just like some of the other programs, like Data Rescue, it brought back the movies, the 2 years of the movies that are lost, but a lot of the back-end files were corrupted. So, either way, I did upgrade to version 5, and ironic enough, the version 5 product doesn't have the scavenge utility. You have to know the name of the file that you're looking for. Stupid. Effing stupid and useless, in my opinion. I also spoke to someone at Tech Support at TechStool Pro. This is published by Micromat, and they also told me that this product is not verified to run on a hard disk system over 2 terabytes. All right, so not really meant for very large volumes. The Alsoft Disk Warrior problem, again, brilliant product. It was able to find files, and like I said, combination, mix and match of the two. If I was to rank them on post hard drive recovery, it's definitely the Data Rescue product and definitely the Disk Warrior product. Good stuff. Tech2 Pro, again, it has preventative maintenance utilities that run on the hard drive to build alternate directory structures, but again, not for a volume over 2 terabytes, and I didn't have the preventative maintenance. I didn't have the condom feature armed on the system. So, be that as it may, I bought all the products. I was able to restore on the edited iMovie data. I was able to restore at least all the file names, so I know what movies I lost. And actually, out of the ones that these programs brought back to life, about 1/5 of them were indeed intact. So there we have it. Now, moving right along, and let me show you some additional hardware as part of my data storage escapades and restoration escapades. Am I using that word right? Whatever, take a look at this crap. From Otherworld Computing, the OWC Mercury Elite Pro enclosure. And this enclosure handles 2 drives. And it has both FireWire 400, 2 800 ports, and USB 2.0. And this particular enclosure is based on RAID 0. RAID 0, which is called striping. So with RAID 0, you're able to put 2 drives, let's say they're 2 500 gigabyte drives. With RAID 0, when the 2 drives are in there, the Macintosh can see it as 1 volume. So the purpose here is that you have 1 1 terabyte volume. It takes the 2 500 gigabyte drives and binds them together. So you get a larger volume with faster speed. But where's the problem? Where's the problem here? You also have now twice the potential for failure rate, because if one drive fails, the whole thing is dead. All right? So keep that in mind. So that's called RAID 0 or striping. So you have to be very careful. Also, when you buy drives off the shelf that say they're 1 terabyte in size, you have to make sure that they're not 2 500 gig drives that are striped internally with hardware in the enclosure. And let me show you that scenario. This is a 1 terabyte Maxtor drive that failed. This one had a physical hardware problem, and this, by being 1 terabyte, was 2 500 drives that were tied together in a RAID 0 fashion. So again, you have to be very careful what you're buying, and that's why this drive is so friggin' robust in size. 2 drives together in RAID 0. So it's not really a true 1 terabyte drive. It's 2 500 gigabyte drives that are rated as striped to give you the 1 large volume and, of course, speed. But one of the 2 drives in here failed, thus bringing down the entire drive and all of the data with it. Now I'm going to power cycle the drive. Maybe you can hear the hard drive go clunk. Of course, so my neighbor's also blasting some music, which is hearing through the wall, but let's hear. Did you hear it? Do you hear that clunk? The click, click, and the clunk? It was trying to bring that second drive online, which it didn't. So this thing, the status is just blinking, is not ready. And you know what's funny with that drive is actually a replacement for a failed drive that the people at Maxtor, now Seagate, replaced under warranty. The first drive I had purchased from them, the FireWire 800 port
failed, and I wanted to have the high-speed drive, so they replaced it with this one. This one, oddly enough, with very minimal use, one of the two striped drives failed, thus bringing down all the data. I did speak with Seagate. Oh, they offer third-party restoration services starting at $3,000, especially when I told them that it was a striped drive. Certainly, doing data restore procedures on a striped drive, you're dealing with data that's dispersed between two drives at the logical level. Very challenging. I said nay, nay. Though I would have liked to have those 2 years of edited movies back. Again, I didn't lose the source material. The source material is backed up redundantly in several places. These aren't film award class movies, so, and certainly not worth a starting point of $3,000. So I did indeed let it go. Now, the mighty, mighty Adam B. does have a suggestion. There's a program called SpinWrite that's been rotting around outside there in the DOS world for like a million years. SpinWrite doesn't give a crap what type of drive it is, what type of format. It does like restoration at the block level. It reads and reads and reseeks and rereads a block, and then it kind of assesses if the data was supposed to be zeros or ones, and then it reallocates the block if there's a bad sector. What I might do is I might pull apart that drive, take out and take out the faulty drive that has that clicking sound, stick it in a PC, and run that program and let it sit and rot for 2 days and see what it does. And then, of course, it has to be put back into this enclosure, because, again, it's set up as a stripe at the hardware level in the drive. So we'll see. That's a real long shot, but it is a valid way as the final attempt to sort of restore the data. Anyway, take a look at this other piece of hardware I have. Now, I had shown you that enclosure from Otherworld Computing, the Mercury Elite Pro. These two drives were actually in Thor before as mirrored drives. In other words, RAID 1, the data on 1 is mirrored on the second drive, and this was done at the software level on OS 10. And though I had put them in this enclosure and I formatted them, I didn't write any data to it. So what I did was I pulled out one of these drives and I put the drive in this neat piece of hardware. I refer to it as a toaster, but basically it lets you take a drive and just insert it, and then there's a USB port and a power supply, and bang, I was able to run some of the disk utility programs, and I was able to restore data on this drive, which was pretty neat, using the ProSoft product, which is called a Data Rescue 2. But I already had the data on here on another volume, so though it did do what it was supposed to do, didn't need to. And I'm actually going to put this back in here and change this back into a RAID 0, scary RAID, just, you know, 1 terabyte volume for not for permanent data storage, just for working files. You know, just to recap a couple of things, drives that are configured as RAID 0 or striped, they offer a large size because you're combining the sizes of the two individual drives, and of course they offer extreme speed. And RAID 1, which is mirrored, offers redundancy. Now the 5 terabyte stardom RAID array, that's RAID 5. It offers a blend of both redundancy and speed, but it still doesn't protect you from a logical error. In other words, the operating system puking and writing out bad data and blowing out the directory. Now, as part of the naming convention, any of my drives that are configured as RAID 0 or striped, I use the word terror, T-E-R-R-O-R, in the naming structure of the volume. So I would refer to one of these drives as a terror RAID or terror array, and anything that's with redundancy, I use something referring to the brain. Like we have one volume called cortex, another one called gray matter, another one called metabrain. All right, so that's the way I distinguish if the drive is RAID 0, striped. Sometimes people call it also scary RAID. Again, to reiterate, if you're in a RAID 0 format and the data was striped, you get the larger volume size and the speed, but also if one of the two drives fails, it takes everything down with it. Anyway, I wanted to share with you my naming convention. It might be useful if you start populating and propagating lots of hard drives to store all your edited movies. In iMovie 06, I'm still not using 09 or Final Slot Pro, whatever. Now here's an interesting drive from Western Digital. This is a MyBook series drive, and they refer to it as the safest place for your data. Notice down here, it references 2 terabytes, but if you look carefully, it's 1+1 terabyte mirrored USB 2.0, which I wasn't too thrilled about, but I needed something locally, so I picked this up at CompUSA. Now, let me do a fake unboxing on the drive. Ta-da! It's unboxed. All right, so here it is. It's an FF-class drive. This is, again, there are 2 1-terabyte drives in here, and it defaults as RAID 1 mirrored. But what I did was I turned this drive into a scary RAID. Why? Because I needed a dumping ground as I was restoring data off the 5-terabyte RAID array. So this comes with a software control panel, and it lets you change it from either safe storage, as in mirrored, and the mirroring is done internal to the hardware of the drive, or you can indeed turn it into a RAID 0 striped scary RAID for more storage, faster throughput, but of course if one of the drives fails, you lose everything. One of the things I had a problem with when I installed the software for this drive, I was looking for the application in the applications folder, but actually it installed it in the top right of the Macintosh desktop interface, so just a little heads up. But that's what this drive is all about. Here, once again, we have the RAID 0 striped enclosure from Otherworld Computing or MacSales.com. And take a look over to the right. Here's another enclosure called the Guardian Maximus, whereas this enclosure at the hardware level has RAID 0 striping, this enclosure at the hardware level has RAID 1 mirroring. So, on this drive, you pop in 2 drives. In here, there are 2 500 gigabyte drives, and it shows up as 1 500 gigabyte drive on the Macintosh desktop, but the data is redundant. So at the hardware level within the drive, as I write data to one drive, it writes it to the second drive. And if you can see on the bottom of this drive, there are 4 LEDs with some language underneath each. One is power, the second one is HDD1, HDD2, and rebuild. So the power light, obviously, when you turn the power on, HDD1 and 2 give you a blue light if the drives are properly working. If one of the drives fails, it turns to red, in which case you replace the drive, and then once you replace the drive, the hardware in the enclosure will automatically rebuild the mirrored RAID array. So there you have nice, safe, and redundant storage. And on this particular drive, I have all the 8mm footage and DAT restoration data from all my legacy videos. Very cool to have this online in one safe spot. So to wrap up this video, I'll be restoring the 5-terabyte RAID array with data from the external drives that were warehoused in the closet, as well as data that was restored using the disk utility programs. The next phase after this is to unbox and install the Drobo. I have a 4-bay Drobo. I have 4 2-terabyte drives, so we're going to max that sucker out, and that's going to be a network storage device, a redundant network storage device. So that will be coming online soon. And then, of course, the unboxing of Octavius is right around the corner. So stay tuned. More to come. This is Alfred.TV at its finest. Are we ever not at our finest? We are now migrating 1 volume of data over to the Soho RAID array from one of the external drives in the closet that is still indeed working. And it's a scary RAID also. It's a RAID 0 drive. And oh, how the little blue lights are a-blinkin'. That means data is being written, and hopefully we're not going to lose it again. Damn. It's a dangerous business, data. And you may ask, oh, Alfred, why the different lighting and camera angle and location? Because I'm in the kitchen. Yes, I'm eating. But listen to me. I'd like to see some video responses. Tell me and tell all the viewers your horror story of how you lost data, how the drive in your laptop crashed, or your tower system, Windows, Macs, Linux, don't care. Tell us your worst horror story. Tell us how you didn't have it backed up. Don't you hate that? When you're talking to someone about a drive that just failed, and the first thing out of their mouth is, well, did you have a backup? Fuck you! No! Why do you think I'm so pissed off? That's the type of response you should give those people. All right? So anyway, do indeed post a video response. Let's hear the horror stories. Even if you recovered the data or you did indeed have a backup, let's hear the horror stories. Compare notes. It helps everyone. It helps the community. It helps us save our precious data. Save the planet? What's more important? actually save the planet, but we still got to save the data anyway. All right, let's see those responses. Thanks for watching.
Sounds like a spaceship from the Jetsons. I feel something on top of my head. What is it? What? I got, there seems to be a small growth on top of my head. I think it's Austin. Nice. This kid's trying to drown me for the past freaking 3 hours, a little brat.
Let me feel.
I'm going to throw him in the pool. I'm going to knock it off.
Let me film!
Yes.
Welcome to Alfred.tv.